Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to compare technical and a little bit performant two-way bass reflex world-class bookshelf speaker. The both of two-way bass reflex bookshelf speaker are vocal Theva N1 against Bowers and Wilkins 707S2. Here we go. Continuous input power is the amount of electrical energy consumed by the woofer and tweeter voice coil. Bowers and Wilkins is 5 watts more than the vocal Theva N2. By the way, in general, many people prefer to have a bookshelf speaker that is heavy. They assume that there are many heavy components such as a thicker cabinet and a bigger magnet. Vocal Theva N1 is weighs 1 kg more than the Bowers and Wilkins. Low frequency driver will not able to reproduce high tones, and conversely, tweeter will not able to reproduce bass sound. To limit the frequency, a crossover circuit is required. In fact, the vocal Theva N1 crossover circuit is more complete. The bass sound reproduced by a larger volume cabinet is generally better. Vocal Theva N1 volume almost twice more bigger than Bowers and Wilkins. Crossover frequency is where the baseline and treble sound intersection, around which there is a decrease in the mid sound. I prefer the 3 kHz one. The SPL of vocal Theva N1 is 99 dB and Bowers and Wilkins is 94 dB. I also show a graph what is the recommended comfortable sound level from NIOSH. Sound pressure level is the result of the pressure variation in the air achieved by the sound wave. Vocal Theva N1 sound is louder at a distance of 5 meters. A frequency response is a ability of a bookshelf speaker to reproduce a range of kind of audio frequency. The wider, the better. And it should be effective and efficient as well. Bowers and Wilkins are better. The cone diameter of woofer mid is different, 35 mm. Material is different, and diameter voice coil of Bowers and Wilkins is 34 mm. And I tend to choose a larger diameter voice coil because it is stronger and more durable. Both the vocal Theva N1 and Bowers and Wilkins 707S2 have the same diameter dimension and type tweeter. But Bowers and Wilkins have resonance suppression behind the magnet. To connect the amplifier output to a bookshelf speaker, people usually need binding posts. The Bowers and Wilkins 707S2 has the capacity of bi-wiring and bi-amping. There is one component, it is foam plug, which is very cheap, and not all bookshelf speakers have it. By adding foam plug, the bass sound will be denser and rounder. Bowers and Wilkins remain loyal to owning it. Even though the Bowers and Wilkins 707S2 has been discontinued, there are still people selling it. Bowers and Wilkins is $150 to $100 cheaper. Vocal Theva N1 is deeper in bass and mid, while Bowers and Wilkins is more in treble. Neither the vocal Theva N1 nor the Bowers and Wilkins have any safety speaker. Besides, there are differences in these two bookshelf speakers. They both also have the same impedance, warranty, various cabinet and grills. In the vocal Theva N1 crossover circuit, there are several passive components such as 3 resistor, 2 capacitor, and 3 inductors. And I have also to present also the crossover circuit in other vocal models. It's like this, similar. This vocal Theva N1 model is really amazing, and it is not too old to look at. The model is quite impressive. Generally, audio lover will definitely like it. Having low frequency cutoff 49 Hz, this means that bass sounds below the frequency of 49 Hz will no longer be heard. With a voice coil diameter of 34 mm, it is quite large indeed. This is a very simple crossover circuit on the Bowers and Wilkins 707S2 bookshelf speaker, and the circuit is not equipped with an inductor filter. This is very dangerous for the tweeter because low frequency will enter the tweeter voice coil. When we open the bracket and midwoofer, it will look like there is fiber inside the speaker cabinet. It has 4 screws, but I think 4 is not enough, at least 6 screws. There is one component that I like more about the high frequency driver of this bookshelf speaker, which is that it has a very complex and good tweeter construction. In my opinion, it is very convincing, and the sound it produces in high tone will be quite good. Bowers and Wilkins still believe and is like Yamaha. They know that the addition of foam plug has an effect on the bass sound. I think Bowers and Wilkins is a little better. Thank you for watching.